Welcome to this TI training. My name is Emmanuel Granatello, and in this video I will go through some of our reference design on power distribution for SoCs and FPGA applications. Microprocessors and programmable logic require several voltage supply rails. These ones often require tight regulation accuracy and sequencing. Discrete solutions are often preferred by designers since they allow layout design flexibility and better address the high efficiency or accuracy versus the board space occupation and costs compared instead to PMIC solutions. We can't fall into designs without recalling a system overview, without talking about discrete versus PMIC power approach and highlighting some of the technical considerations behind the problem. After this brief introduction, we will see the features of three different power trees, made for respectively Altera MAX10, IMX7 multicore processor, and Freescale MPC automotive microcontroller. A typical system on chip configuration and its supply rails will look like in this example. We will find most likely a core voltage, which is necessary in order to power up the processing unit, an analog voltage for the analog circuitry, and IO's voltages, usually placed between 1.5 and 3.3 volt, and an auxiliary voltage in order to power up all the auxiliary circuitry like PLL, peripherals, and L control units. In turn, these rails must be derived by an intermediate power source, which usually is presented and identified as a 12 volt, 5 volt, or 3.3 volt voltage rail. Each one of these options presents pros and cons, and for example, if we take into account the 5 volt range, it will have a fairly high efficiency conversion to the point of load, while the input current will be higher compared to the 12 volt range, which instead has a lower efficiency conversion to the point of load and possible duty cycle limitation due to the low conversion ratio from, for example, 12 volt to 1.2. Also, 3.3 volt as intermediate rail is a valid option because of the higher efficiency in the conversion to the point of load, but also it presents the highest input currents and there are fewer available parts due to the minimum Vin range. Here are list the Xilinx Zinc 7000 system on chip voltage rails with their accuracies and their estimated current consumption using the Xilinx power estimator. Considering the VCC INT rail, we can figure out how challenging it is to satisfy the required plus minus 50 millivolt accuracy, not only in a DC domain, which still needs to be properly addressed, but especially in the AC, since one could encounter load transients of 5 ampere or so, depending on the final application. These two pictures show how a PMIC on the left and a discrete power tree on the right will look like on a PCB. To keep the comparison fair, the peaks have been put on scale. Because of EMI prevention, on a PMIC board, the power devices must be placed on the same side of the PMIC. These include the inductors, the capacitors, but also the external power FETs, which often are needed for high current rails in order to move the heat dissipation outside the main IC. A discrete power tree allows instead the power converter to be placed on both sides of the PCB, given that the passive of each converter are placed on the same side and as close as possible to each one of the single ICs. Because of less heat concentration, a single IC with integrated FET will be able to dissipate the heat produced by the highest currents. The DC-DC converters from the TPS62000 series from Texas Instruments do not need external compensation network, enabling them faster design and debug cycles. This is possible only because the compensation is designed and realized on silicon internally, in order to minimize the transient response in relation to the specific control topology enumerating condition. This approach leaves the choice of input-output filtering, inductor and capacitor, to the customer, within specific and simple value tables and guidelines found in each datasheet. Specifically for FPGA application, it's important to design an effective power distribution network, which in case of discretes results an easier task to do, thanks to the less parasitic introduced by the PCB traces. A common denominator in this kind of devices is the fact that there is no need of low frequency type bulk capacitor because of the high bandwidth and high switching frequency of those ICs. In order to enhance the efficiency at light loads, many SMPS support a power safe mode, which is implemented through pulse frequency modulation. This consists in decreasing the switching frequency at light loads by means of the dynamic control law, reaching hence amazing and unbeatable efficiency values even when your application is in standby mode. Though the flip side of that is the ripple and especially the DC error that will increase because of the control pulse frequency modulation, since it is very similar to an hysteretic mode. This will introduce the concrete risk of not satisfying the narrow accuracy requested for the SoC's voltages. So, in most of the cases, the suggestion is to choose devices where the PWM mode can be forced by means of an additional pin. Said that, let's discover some of the ICE power reference designed for these applications. The power tree for the Intel MAX10 FPGA has been designed to support the harshest industrial environments. Indeed, it uses two TPS62197 for the IOs and ADCs voltages and the TPS62480 for the main core. Both these devices are rated up to 125 degrees C. And with rated, I mean that the key specifications like the VREF accuracy are kept within the datasheet limits over the whole temperature range. For standby and fast wakeups, the Altera MAX10 uses an instant-on feature which this design supports by means of an optional load switch as well as the option of dual supply. Grid the flexibility at the startup sequence thanks to the adjustable soft start and the practical non-programming needings by the use of enable power good cascade. From the board's picture, one can see how effective this design is in space-constrained systems, still keeping a low self-heating rate. You can find this and other designs on the TI.com website by searching with their TIDA keyword. For the Altera MAX10 power design, the code is TIDA01366, and you can find, together with the schematic and layout, a complete design guide. When dealing with the NXP IMX7 microprocessor, one can immediately notice that the accuracy needed on the power pins is actually a specification more relaxed. This allows the use of power safe mode feature for enhancing the efficiency at low load and making this design perfect for ultra low power applications and cost effective applications. The TLV6208X family approach indeed plays a big role in this field. Plus, it makes the design scalable for other higher or lower consuming processors of the same series. Sequencing requirements can be easily achieved by the use of the LM388X sequencer, which needs no programming. These features make the design suitable for IoT and factory automation applications, where battery-operated end equipment must run for as long as possible. EPOS terminals and embedded computer application also find this useful thanks to the little space of occupation of the power design. Schematics layout and user guide can be found on TI.com under the TIDA01416 design folder. In the automotive environment, the NXP microcontroller MPC5748G is largely used. We have hence provided here a power distribution which is AEC Q100 qualified, with VIN supported from 2.7 to 16 volts, and that supports also 32 volts peaks. When compared to a PMIC approach, This design wins thanks to the 1% DC accuracy on the 1.3 volt core voltage rail, and also because of the easy implemented sequencing, which is realized with the enabled power good cascade, and that hence needs no programming. The solution results compact and highly efficient. Plus, each rail can be upgraded to the higher pin-to-pin family device for further processor and for heavier applications. Also, this project can be found on ti.com under the project folder TIDA01412. On the FPGA support page on the TI's website, you can find a complete guidance tool to select the devices for a complete solution for a large variety of microprocessors, microcontroller, SoCs and FPGA. As we can notice from this example, the suggestions for each voltage rail of a selected chip are comprehensive of PMIC and discrete approaches, and they are tailored on a different application specification, that means the input voltage and the load current of the chip. With this, we are done for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and that it will be useful for your present and future projects. See you at the next one and enjoy your design. Ciao!